Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can calculate sum of elements available at even index in 1D array. Before starting, you can note my information. You can watch and subscribe my YouTube channel through this URL, that is youtube.com/SanjayGupta_TechSchool. You can download my programming app TechMS that is available on Google Play. Now I am going to implement a code for you which will calculate sum of elements that are available at even index in 1D array. First of all, I am including a header file, that is stdio.h. Then main function. Inside main, I am first declaring an array. Its size is 10. Then I variable, it will be used for loop control. And then s, which is initialized with 0. It will be containing sum. Then I am using printf statement. This printf will display enter 10 elements message on console. To receive these 10 numbers, I am implementing a for loop. For loop is started from 0, condition is i less than 10, and increment part is i++. So this loop will repeat 10 times. With this loop, I am implementing scanf statement, which will receive 10 integers. Inside array A, at different indexes, which will be provided with the variable I. So this scanf statement is reading a particular element, and that element will be stored at A of I position. So A is name of array and I is representing index. So I is started from 0 and it will end to 9. So from 0 to 9, total 10 indexes will be filled through this scanf statement. Now I have to add those elements which are available at even index. So again, I am implementing for loop. This time I am applying if condition. Condition is I modulus 2 double equals to 0. So I is representing index. So if index is divisible by 2, it means index is representing even index. So s equals to s plus a of I. So this way, the elements which are available at even indexes will be added inside S. After completion of for loop, I can print sum on console using this printf statement. So this is complete implementation of the program. Now I am going to execute this code. You can see it is asking for 10 elements. So I am entering 1 10 times. So it should be printing 5. You can see it is printing 5 because from index 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8, all indexes are containing 1. So sum is 5. Now if I want to remove this if condition, it is also possible. Now I am removing this if condition. And I am modifying this increment part. I equals to I plus 2. So this way, index will be incremented by 2 every time. So initially it is 0. So 0 index will be added with s variable. Then I will become 2. So by incrementing I with 2, it will be providing only even indexes values, and that will be added inside s. Now again I am executing this code. I am entering 10 times 1. You can see the output. It is again printing sum equals to 5. Now what if I want to remove this for loop, second for loop, and I just want to calculate sum of elements which are available at even index through single loop. So I am removing this for loop. Now I am using this loop which is reading elements from the user. and inside this loop I am applying if condition. So now you can see this for loop, it is reading an element. Now if is checking the index, if index I is divisible by 2, then only A of I will be added to S, and this process will repeat until this condition is false. So this way all the elements will be stored inside array, and those elements which are available at even indexes will be added to S. After completion of this loop, S will be printing the sum on console. So now again I am executing this code. This time I am entering numbers like this, 1, 2, 1, 2. So you can see at even indexes I have entered only 1, and at odd indexes I have entered 2. So this time also it is showing sum equals to 5. So this way I have demonstrated you 3 different ways to calculate sum of the elements which are available at even indexes. Now if you want to calculate sum of the elements which are available at odd indexes, you can just convert this condition I modulus 2 not equals to 0. So if index is not divisible by 2, then it will be representing odd index. So this program will print sum of elements which are available at odd indexes. So I hope you have understood all the possibilities which I have demonstrated to you. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can follow my YouTube channel through the URL, that is youtube.com/SanjayGupta_TechSchool. You can also download my programming app, that is Techamaze, which is available on Google Play. So if you want to learn programming, you can connect with me. Programming is fun. If you do practice regularly, you can easily understand all the concepts which are available in programming languages. Thank you for watching this video. Keep connected with me. Thank you.